All right, boys and girls, welcome back again. Tone King here, coming at you live from the Tone Lounge. I have today the DOD Compressor 280. DOD is, you know what? DOD is a comfort pedal. They've been around for a long time. They're known good pedals, metal construction, true bypass. Lots of design and engineering have gone into the reissue series. And they're in the pedal business, right? There's a lot of pedal companies out there. We all know that. But these guys have been doing it for a long time, and I'm happy and proud to have the Compressor 280 up over here. Real simple pedal. You have a compressor and a level. And, you know, sometimes when I do these videos, I ask myself, how could I demonstrate a pedal or a product or anything for that matter that sometimes is a subtle effect? But I think I got this one. So if you want to know what a compressor pedal does, here we go. A compressor increases the soft stuff and squashes the high stuff. It compresses, right? So typically you would have something like this, like soloing, you'd use compression. Or if you're doing like clean funk where there's a lot of like dynamic and you're playing, it crunches that down. So if I turn my guitar on, I'm not going to kill the vocal mic because I want to talk while I'm going through this. But if I play something soft like this and I put it on, you could see it raise that volume a little bit because I played it very soft. Now, if I play something really hard, I'm going to kill the vocal mic for this. If I play something really hard and I click this button, you'll see it'll bring it down a little bit. Watch. So you got to see what it actually does. When I play it without the compressor, it sounds a little bit more dynamic, but the compressor is supposed to make it less dynamic. It's supposed to compress it. Now, you say, what would I use that for? On a dirty channel, sometimes you could use leads. I'm not the best lead guitar player. I know that. You don't have to leave a comment and tell me that. I know that. So especially for the average Joe that wants to do a lead, sometimes it comes across a little sloppy. And when you try to do something, there's a lot of highs and there's a lot of lows, and you could use a compressor to compress that. So I'll try to give you an example of before and after. Check it out. So you should have seen that when I did it with the compressor, it actually articulated the notes a little bit better because, you know, my playing is a little inconsistent. It's a little high, it's a little low. Some fingers press down harder than others, but the compressor does exactly what it's supposed to. It raises the stuff that's soft and it squashes the stuff that's high. So you have this compression knob right over here, and then you have a level. So if you want to actually boost the hook, compress it, but still raise the volume. So if you think about it, you have highs and you have lows. If you want to compress it, but still raise the whole volume of the compressed sound, you could do that too. So that's what a compressor does, and hopefully this demo gave you an opportunity to see and understand for yourself. With that said, I'll give you a little some licks and riffs before and after. Check it out. Here we go. So now let's take a look at what a compressor could do on a clean channel. So here is our clean. Use the neck pickup for this. So let's say your sound man is like, dude, you know, you're trying to do some like James Brown funk, whatever, and your sound man is like, WTF, dude, you're all over the place, my levels are peaking, and I'm looking at my levels right now. So what you could do is throw the compressor on. Remember, you have the level, so you could roll the level back. You could get something very consistent and then just bring the level up to where you want it to be. In fact, I'm going to kill the vocal mic so all you hear is the compressed sound. Check it. So there you go. Real kind of funky. You know, compressors make that funky. You know why? Because you could really rock out without making your levels rock out. And let's face it, if you're recording, levels rocking out aren't so good. Usually you want to be within a range, and the compressor puts you in that range. So there it is, DOD Compressor 280. Thank you for watching my video. I hope you enjoyed it. I'll leave you all off with one of those bad boys right there. Thanks as always for watching. And until next time, rock on. Later.